Today I'm going to have a go at this golden Fifth Avenue arch top. Looks pretty cool. My friend said they're worth about 500 bucks. He grabbed this one used for 300 bucks. It seems to be in fair condition, just very poorly adjusted. So I guess I'll do a video about how to set up an arch top. Hold on. So we're going to be putting a set of these on 12 to 52. Arch tops traditionally have heavy strings, and sometimes even heavier than this. I've seen guys use 14 to 60 on an arch top. So if I wasn't going to have to set up the whole guitar because the bridge is... Hey there! The bridge is moved. I would only change one string at a time to avoid trauma, and then that way this, assuming it's in the correct position, would stay put. But unfortunately this is very maladjusted, I can tell just by looking at it. So we're going to take all the strings off it, and the first step to setting up any guitar, or, and you guys, you know, beat me up if you want to, there's guys out there beating me up. I gotta get the neck as perfectly straight as possible. This is how we're gonna start. Under string tension. So we'll stand by a minute. Okay, so the bridge on an arch top should be approximately 1 inch high. If the bridge is way lower than that, or way higher than that, there's a chance that the neck angle isn't right. So if you're looking at used arch tops, check out to see how high this is cranked or how low it is cranked, and that'll be an indication as to whether the neck angle is screwed up. Check it out, I got that squirrel shaved off my head. So if you have to remove the bridge and it is in the right spot, then we'd use a couple little pieces of tape to mark the position where that would go. And okay, so I gotta just clean this up a little bit, and then I'm gonna get strings on it, and we'll go through the other little bits and pieces of setting this up. Once again, the right wrench. This to me is almost a real serious engineering blunder. 4 millimeter and 5/32 of an inch. This 5/32, which is what you're going to find. We're in North America. Imperial's been here. It's 4/1000 of an inch too small, and consistently strips these because it's metric. So anyway, folks, be very careful that you use the right key, and if your guitar came with a key, make sure you hang on to it, because sometimes they're made with an extra long side, or they're made in a slightly special way to overcome things that happen trying to get in there to do it. So anyhow, cannot stress enough, have the right tool. And somebody cracked off about my bench being a mess and, you know, sloppy, and you know what? Here's the deal. When you watch those videos on YouTube where the bench is like hospital clean and everything's like perfect, like cleaner than your house, that's a real good indication that nothing ever actually happens there. Because this is the shop dummies domain. That's how you learn what the tools are. You come and put them away for the guy who's using them. Once again, a little inspection for fret wear, and there's really none. The fretboard's dry and a little dirty, and we're going to go and clean it up with 2000 grit wet dry sandpaper and some linseed oil. And boy, am I going to get the gears about the linseed oil, but we'll continue with that little discussion later.
So while I was cleaning the guitar, the nut just came loose, and that's fine, it's a tiny drop of glue holding that in place. But I'm sidetracked now, and I want to show you guys something really cool. Because this is a Tusk synthetic material nut. This one is a Gibson replacement. Bench tested, builder approved. This is a replacement for a Les Paul. They're both synthetic materials, but I'm going to do a little demo here, and you'll see why I like the Tusk. This is cool. Check this out.
Okay, so this is the Gibson, and I'm going to just drop it on the concrete floor and listen carefully. Okay, I'll do that again. Okay, so you heard the sound. This is the Tusk. When you do the same thing with a Tusk, listen. Here, it sings its own frickin' note. Check it out. Isn't that neat? And here's the Gibson synthetic material, plastic. That's what you get, dud. Or, that's why I like this stuff, even over bone. I wish I had a piece of bone here, was a nut that could show you. It's even sounds more bad than plastic. Cool.
So I gotta figure out where the bridge goes. So I'm gonna measure it, but I'm gonna do it a little differently. The straight edge goes right up against the nut. And you're going to take a fine point marker and put a little mark where the 12th fret is, and then copy that dimension back there. And that should be a within a very close margin, the position of where the bridge needs to go. So you can sort of see from the other picture when it was like way back here and cranked. That probably had a lot to do with the unplayability. But anyway, okay, so that's my ballpark. Let's get the two E strings on it to hold this guy in place and string it up, make her go.
Yeah, this is sweet. So the bridge is pretty much to the deck now. And when I put the straight edge across the frets, it hits the top of the bridge. So that's what we'd like to see. Sweet, let's get the strings on it.
So that worked out great. I got two E strings. I got this positioned in relation to the 12th fret. Let's get the rest of the strings on it. So now that I got the two E's, I'll adjust the intonation on the guitar for both of these. And however the bridge compensates, I can't really change that. But that's sort of the deal. This gets intonated, that gets intonated by slightly tweaking this back and forth. And away we go! So as I'm adding each string, I'm constantly putting a bit more tension to the truss rod to keep the neck perfectly straight.
Well, it's pretty thin sounding. And I would not recommend these half wound things. They just feel like dirty strings to me. 500 bucks I wouldn't pay. 300 bucks. It's worth 300 bucks. I'm going to do something here for different for a demo here. Hold on. So I dropped her down to an open D. I like that a lot better than a slide thing, other than calluses. Okay, now I'm gonna play my crappy old K. This is thinner than the K. My K is about an inch wider. So, for a practice guitar and the tuners I don't think are very good. Here comes the K. Okay, this is my shitty old K from 1962. Same bridge. See, I've got heavy bronze strings on it. He had me put steel on there, and that's why. I don't know, man. I think I'm gonna go run with the K. But I guess, if you could get one of these at a good price, it seems like a lot of fun. A great knockaround guitar for sure. It seems really solid. Okay, cheers folks. What do we got? It is a Godin Fifth Avenue Archtop. Cheers. Enjoy. We're going to get to that other crazy guitar tomorrow, I hope.